Kerala, the land of infinite beauty and cultural diversity. Summer is the time of festivity. Thousands gather at temples to pay obeisance and listen to the music of the drums and the trumpets. The majestic elephants, bedecked in gold, add grandeur to the scene. Kerala is also home to the Indian wild elephant. Where else can you see them so close as here in Periyar Tiger Reserve, one of the best protected areas of the country? Take a boat ride through the famous Periyar Lake. If the season is right, you are sure to see herds of elephants. Gaur, sambar deer, wild dogs by the lakeside. The tigers of Periyar are truly wild. The casual visitor rarely gets to see the lord of the jungle, but its presence is very real to the denizens of the forest. The forests around the lake are thousands of years old, but not the lake. It was formed when the Mulla Periyar Dam was constructed in 1895 across River Periyar to nourish the fallow plains of Tamil Nadu. At the top of a grassy mountain on the eastern flank of the sanctuary stand the ruins of the Mangala Devi Temple. Silent testimony to a war fought between the local Punjar king and Tipu, the Sultan of Mysore, in 1770. Elephants are the biggest of all land mammals. They spend a lot of time foraging. As a matter of fact, 3/4 of its entire lifetime is spent in feeding. They do not chew the cud like deer and gaur. Instead, they eat it slowly, chewing it even as we do. As they go about their business of feeding, you can see their enormous ears flapping constantly. This is to bring down its body temperature. In less than 20 minutes, the entire blood in an elephant's body passes through the veins of its ears. The elephant's trunk is indeed its most amazing appendage. No other animal has such a specialized nose, a nose so long, so strong, so supple, so useful. No wonder that it is made up of 150,000 muscles. To bathe, to spray mud over its body as an after-bath talcum, to pick up tiny objects, or tear apart larger ones, to smell and sniff out possible sources of danger, all these are done with the help of the trunk. It also uses the trunk to drink water. A very much smaller and delightful insect of this forest also uses its proboscis as a straw to suck up its food. Butterflies. They are the darlings of the insect world. There are hundreds of varieties here, some very small, hardly a centimeter across, others quite large, like this bird wing butterfly with a wingspan of more than 6 inches. Some are drab, others very colorful and exquisite. It would seem that a butterfly's life is a bed of roses. But never so. During all stages of its development, it has enemies: ants, wasps, spiders, birds. A single red weaver ant may seem powerless to tackle a caterpillar 100 times its size, but when it comes to teamwork, size poses no problem. Among wild animals, there is the wild dog, which uses teamwork to maximum efficiency. They hunt in packs. Sambar, the largest deer in India, is its favorite prey. They can be seen in large numbers here. Once a prey is marked, the dogs chase it until it is exhausted. Often, the final ambush takes place in water. The Periyar Tiger Reserve has many swampy areas, or vials. These are the stomping grounds of gaur, often wrongly called the Indian bison. The gaur, with its unmistakable stockinged feet, is the largest bovine in the world. An adult can easily weigh more than a ton. You have to be a keen observer to see the graceful barking deer. It is often seen around the boat landing. Hush! Listen. Was that the bark of the deer after which it gets its name? Four out of the five primates found in the Western Ghats live in the reserve. The only primate which is not found here is the Hanuman langur. This bonnet macaque gorges on yummy jackfruit. Who knows what the next meal shall consist of? Indeed, mummy's milk is always the best. One could spend hours watching the monkeys up to tricks. The bonnets have a field day with tourist vehicles. As you walk along the road to the boat landing, look up into the trees. You might see some black monkeys up there with a ruff around their faces. They are the Nilgiri langur found in the Western Ghats and nowhere else in the world. They are shy, but if you position yourself carefully, you could be privy to their life up in the trees. This predominantly vegetarian animal feeds on a variety of leaves, buds, flowers and fruits. Another rarely seen primate is the slender loris. During the day, it hides in tree hollows or in a leafy cover. Its movements are extremely slow. No matter where the mother moves, the young one clings on. What have we here? It's the brilliantly coloured Malabar giant squirrel. They are a perennial source of delight with their acrobatics and courtship games. The mist-covered grasslands of Mangala Devi and Kumarikulam are home to elephants and bear. Besides these large mammals, this area is a treasure trove, rare orchids. Wild balsams, insectivorous Drosera, and Nilgiri Tar, the highly endangered mountain goat of South India. Their total population does not exceed 2,000. Another rarity here is the striped-necked mongoose, the largest mongoose in Asia. Crabs and fish are its hot favorites. The rich bird life includes diurnal and nocturnal bird species. More than 320 of the 525 bird species recorded in Kerala are recorded here. On the 2 kilometer stroll from the park entrance to the boat landing, an astute bird watcher may catch glimpses of a large number of birds, like the spotted dove, Shikra, grey-headed canary flycatcher, yellow-billed babbler, white-bellied treepie, black-rumped flame bat, rufous woodpecker, racket-tailed drongo, chestnut-tailed starling, hill miner, grey jungle fowl, Malabar whistling thrush, the colourful and handsome Malabar trogon, Oriental Scops Owl, Spot-bellied Eagle Owl, Mottled Wood Owl. If you are exceptionally lucky, you could even come across the rare Sri Lankan Frog Mouth or the Peninsula Bay Owl. Slithering through the high elevation forest floor is this hump-nosed pit viper. Skinks are a favorite food item. Young vipers have a remarkable ability to lure them by wriggling their white tail tips. Among the 45 species of reptiles recorded here, some others are the green vine snake, Malabar pit viper, large-scaled pit viper, the Indian python, and the colorful golden tree snake. The giant monitor lizard is a common reptile of the reserve. But the tree dragon, or the Calotes grandisquamis, is very rare. It lays eggs inside a pit dug out by itself. After laying is over, the lizard expertly covers the hole with mud and debris. Several weeks later, the eggs hatch. The young ones are left to fend for themselves. Tropical forests have a superabundance of insects in all sizes, shapes and colors. They play a crucial role in recycling the forest biomass. Like insects, spiders too abound in this tropical forest. This spider web symbolizes the rich tapestry of life inside a forest ecosystem, where every living thing is connected to the other in one way or the other. If one strand is broken, it tells upon the efficiency of the spider's web. In the same way, any disturbance to any part of the forest affects the entire system. As summer advances, the water level of the lake begins to fall. Streams and water holes within the forest dry up. The lake now becomes the only water source for birds and animals. Summer is also the nesting season for birds. The scimitar babbler and the endemic Nilgiri verditer flycatcher have already built nests and laid their eggs. There seems to be a competition for space here. The Malabar grey hornbill is at a loss, since it was the same tree cavity that it occupied last year. Hornbills have very interesting and quite unique nesting habits. When it is time for laying, the female enters a tree cavity and then seals the entrance with her own droppings from the inside. opening to the nest is now a narrow slit through which her mate feeds her by regurgitating. Only after the eggs hatch does the female break out of its self-enforced confinement. Fledglings too emerge when they are ready to face the world. But the star bird of the reserve is a great pied hornbill. It nests deep in the woods, in a hollow, high up on a tree, and returns year in and year out to the very same nest. Pre-monsoon showers bring a much-needed respite. Fresh grasses spring up on the parched land. Golden leaves uncurl in the forest. Winged ants emerge in large numbers from their underground homes. Perhaps in the hope of making new colonies. Most, however, end up as a tea time snack for birds and squirrels. By the month of May, rain clouds start building up over the Arabian Sea. They travel east and, crashing on the mountains of the Western Ghats, pour down as the southwest monsoon, laying the foundation for all life here. Forest streams flow anew as a monsoon brings with it life-giving rain. Trees put forth new leaves and flowers. Butterflies emerge from their cocoons. insects buzz around. It is the celebration of life everywhere. The forests of Periyar Tiger Reserve are ready for one more year of glorious life. These forests, with all their sentient and non-sentient beings, are an indivisible part of the universe we inhabit. Let us too, like the forests, rejoice at being alive. Let us, like nature, strive towards a life of joy, harmony, and peace.